to help celebrate Mother's Day with the Reverend Helen Gilcrease. We are giving her this beautiful flower. God bless you. Just relax and enjoy the service. Sister Helen Gilcrease is a wonderful, wonderful lady, a wonderful mother. I'm sure you'll enjoy. God bless.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Carolyn Hill Williams, and I just want to introduce my baby girl, Sharon Rochelle Thomas, to Union Oak Church. Sharon is a rising star. So, Sharon, I'm happy to see you today. I'm happy that she came to share in this Mother's Day adventure. She was able to help me out on last night. See, God always have a plan. When one thing fails, he always got a ram in the bush. And she was my ram. It's amazing that my daughter come in here from Louisville, Kentucky, 10 hours, and she was able to stand in and be that ram for me. And I just thank God. And I just wanted to let you guys know, Sharon Rochelle. Happy birthday.
Thank you. keep on fooling me. And before long, the Spirit of the Lord is going to get in here. And something on the inside is going to stir up. Because when I think about the goodness of the Lord and all that is done for me, I can't help but give God the praise. I know. We're supposed to wait for the drums to get going.
Amen. 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 Am
Creed by Sister Carolyn Weed.
Amen.
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 May we stand, please. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is one church, apostolic, universal, whose holy faith let us now reverently and sincerely declare. What do we believe?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered on the cross of Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sits on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty, from thence to come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Before we have our morning prayer, if you are male in this place,
my Lord,
could you stand up and give our mothers a kudos hand clap? You are male. Thank you, boy. Look at your male here. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Honored and deserved.
Amen.
Those of you who know me know that I'm a talker, even Reverend Helen Gilchrist. You know when I text her back and forth, I'm a text her back and forth, so sometimes we just have to quit.
Uh-huh.
So what I'm going to do today is kind of bring it down a little bit.
Okay, Sister Mary.
And first of all, we're going to have our morning prayer. And Sister Evers is kind of under the weather today, so we're going to have morning prayer by Sharon Williams Thomas.
Amen.
And we're going to have a selection after that. Once she do that, she's going to sing, give us a selection.
Amen.
And then after that, we're going to have the announcements. And then I'll come back after the announcements, which is going to be by our sound attendant.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Good morning, church family.
Good morning.
Good morning, family.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. Just wanted to greet you before we enter into prayer. I love you guys. It is always awesome to be home.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, hallelujah, we just thank you for this day. We honor you and we say that you are invited to be here, to come in and to have your way.
Amen.
It has been said that you are a God that sits high and looks low. But not only do you sit high and look low, but you are a God that dwells with your people. And right now, Father, we say thank you for being a God that dwells with us and in us, a God that never leaves us, a God that never forsakes us. Today we take some time to honor you, to say thank you for being such a good, good Father, for providing the things that we need, for loving us, Father God, for nurturing us. And as we celebrate this day of mothers, we thank you, Father, that you are a nurturer, that mothers have the ability to give because of you, because you have given to us. We honor you. God, I thank you for every person present in this place today, that you know all of our needs, Father, and I thank you that they have been supplied. So we reach out today and we grab what you have released. We thank you even for the word today that's coming forth. We thank you for the speaker, Father God, what you have placed on the inside of her, Father God, and what will be released to us today. God, we magnify and praise your holy name. We thank you even for this city, for this town that we are in, Father, for what you are doing in our nation, Father, for what you are doing in our world, Father, that the plans and purposes, your plans and purposes, among us, Father God. We release the word of healing in the name of Jesus. We thank you for your healing virtue. We thank you, Father, that by your stripes that we are healed. So we reach out and we receive the healing that is flowing to us, that you have given to us. Father God, we thank you for all of your many blessings and your promises. And Father, in the areas where we may not see those promises, we do not lack faith, Father God. We do not even begin to believe that you can't do it, Father God. But we stand in a position of thankfulness and gratefulness for what we do have. We thank you, Father.
Love you, God.
We come with hearts of gratefulness and thankfulness this morning. You're so, so good. Thank you that you meet me. Thank you for your unconditional love. We thank you for your forgiveness. That the reason that we are standing here today is not because we are righteous of ourselves, but our righteousness is of you, Jesus. We thank you for your blood that has covered all of our wrongdoing, Father. We thank you, Father, that you see, when you look at us, that you see you, that you see Jesus, and that you choose not to look at our mistakes, that you choose not to look at the shortcomings. But I thank you that you have called us up higher. And we walk in that, Father. Have your way today. Have your way today, Father. You know all things. You created all things. Father God, you spoke it. And I thank you for the words that you are speaking and releasing over us. Thank you.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We will be mindful of the words that we speak to you. We will be mindful of the things that we say. And we don't come just releasing words, but we come before you, Father, boldly before your throne because you say so. Because we are your children. And we come before you knowing that you have taken care of it all. We thank you, Father, for whatever situations that are being faced right now, whatever mountains that are there. We thank you, Father, that you are strengthening us to walk through it. We thank you for strength. We thank you for joy. We thank you for deliverance. The things in our lives, even the things, Father, that may be out of order. We thank you, Father, that you are a God of order, that you are putting those things in order. So we as your children, we come before you today. We thank you that you are here because we are gathered in your name. There's many of us in this room, and we are gathered here in your name, Lord Jesus. And we know that we are gathered in your name, that you are here in the midst, that you inhabit the praises of your people. And today, we come in this room with a praise on our lips, with a praise in our mouth, releasing to you, saying that we praise you, we magnify you, we bless your name. Hallelujah, you are the greatest. There is nobody like you. You are the greatest of all time. And we trust you, even in moments of fear, Father, we trust you. Even in moments when we don't understand, we trust you. Even in moments of struggle, Father, we trust you. We trust you because you always keep your word and you always look out for us. God, we honor you. We love you. We trust you.
We trust you, Lord.
And we thank you for being so close. Closer than the air that we breathe.
Oh, my God.
Closer than the air in our lungs. That you breathe life into us.
Oh, my Lord.
And we became a living soul. And we thank you,
God,
that it is done. And as you said, Jesus, it is finished.
Yes.
It is finished. We don't have to strive.
Oh,
we thank you for the peace that you're even releasing in this room right now. Peace that passes all, surpasses all understanding. How can we face the things that we face and be in peace? It is because of you and all that you release. We honor you and we magnify you.
Oh, my God.
We thank you. Thank you. In your name,
Jesus,
we pray and we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah, that's a good place to give a praise right there. Hallelujah. in the good
and
the bad.
Oh,
hallelujah. What appears to be bad. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, this.
Hallelujah.
Some of you may have heard that Dad had to go to the hospital yesterday.
Amen.
So he ended up, Mom was down here and I was in Hope Mills. And my dad ended up having to call the ambulance while he was home. He was by himself. And my husband ended up, he was looking for all of us.
Amen.
And he ended up, kept calling, and he ended up getting Dad's phone. And Dad was in the ambulance saying, they're taking me to the hospital. And so he thought that my mother and I were the ones taking him. So when he called me, I was like, Dad, what? And so he's in the hospital right now. But glory to God,
Amen.
It is well.
Amen.
It is well.
Yes.
His father, Heavenly Father, is looking out for him.
Yes,
he's good.
He
I kept hearing this song. I don't even actually know all of the verses, but I'm going to make this thing work. Which is, I heard it because when I even think about being here, you know, I honor the presence of God in this house, and to the pastor, I honor you, sir. To all the family,
Amen.
We are family. And I think about,
Amen.
You know, growing up here and being taught in, you know, Sunday school convention and all of these things that are a part of who I am. And I was thinking about, I knew I was going to be asked to sing, and I was like, you know what, the song that was on my heart was, God has smiled on me. He has set me free. Oh, saved a wretch like me.
done in your life. Something starts at the bottom of your feet and moves up through your leg and gets in your belly, and you can't just sit still. All you can do is think about who God is and what he's done, and it makes you want to say glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, you don't have to sit on your praise. If God has smiled on you, that is your testimony on this morning, that God has been good. Ain't nothing wrong with putting your hand in the air and saying, God, I thank you. Hallelujah. God has been so good. So good to me. Hallelujah.
Speaker by our very own Good morning, Union Oak.
Good morning.
After what's been going on, I'm pretty sure that people are probably not looking to hear a voice from the deep come in. But I want to wish, before I get started with all the announcements, on a sad note, if you haven't heard already, Brother Archie Brown passed this morning.
Oh, man.
So just keep the family in prayer.
Amen.
You know, Brother Brown was a longtime member here.
Yes, sir. Amen.
So keep him in prayer. And I'm pretty sure that as soon as details are made, they'll be forthcoming. Also, I'd like to wish all the mothers a happy Mother's Day.
Amen.
Especially to my bride, the mother of my two children. Of course, if you talk to her, she'd probably say that it was three children. But if you talk to my granddaughter, she'll probably say that that she's my mother. And my real mother is my stepmother. But I just want to say to the young people, honor your mother.
Yes, sir.
Mother's going to be gone one day.
Amen.
My mother used to often tell me that all the time. So I'm wearing the color brown today because it was her favorite color. And I'm doing that in order to honor my mother. So happy Mother's Day to all the mothers.
Amen.
Our thought for the week, if at first you don't succeed, try doing it the way mothers see.
Hey.
How about that?
All right.
These are your announcements.
That's all right.
Anyone wishing to work on the homecoming committee for 2022 should see Sister Karen McGugan ASAP. You are invited to join the deaconess on Wednesday at noon for prayer and meditation. The link can be found on the front of your morning program. Anyone interested in working with the Union Oak Summer Enrichment Program should see Sister Brenda Williams as soon as possible. This is to include food service and tutoring. Sister Francine Island would like to meet with all the men after church for a quick meeting, business of importance. If you are a president of a club or board or a club leader and you would like to add comments to your quarterly conference report, you have until the fourth Sunday to turn your comments in to Sister Sabrina Hicks.
Mm-hmm.
The form to add your comments will be located on the usher table. A special thank you to everyone that traveled to St. James on Thursday evening. Your dedication and commitment does not go unnoticed. Parents, as your child prepares for the end of grade testing this week, please make sure that they get a good night's rest.
Yep.
And a good breakfast for champions. Most of all, stop and pray with your child that they will be successful on their tests each day.
Yes.
To all educators, you may be a teacher, a teacher's assistant, bus driver, custodian, food service worker, or administrator. We, the members of Union Oak, would like to thank each of you for your dedication and commitment to each of the students that you work with. Be assured that some little child is looking at you and learning from you each day. Just a note of thanks, because you may think that you are just doing your part to make the world go around. But to some child, you are their world.
Amen.
The seeds planted today will bloom tomorrow. We appreciate each and every one of you. May God's blessings continue to be upon you. Got a little sticker here from Brother Roscoe. One stop voting here in Cumberland County is from April 28th through May 14th, which means next Saturday is the last day for early voting. Get out and let your voice be heard. I know this is primary, but get out and let your voice be heard. And I know some of you have been paying attention to what's been going on in the news all this week. Think about this. Could it be that God is trying to tell us something? May God bless you. And God continue to turn it over now back to the MC for the program.
Carolyn, I know you had something you wanted to share in regarding to that. I'm expecting space for you at this time.
Good morning, church family.
Morning.
All of you that came out to the hat show on yesterday, I thank you so very much for your support. The ones of you that did not come to the hat show, if you would like a hat, I want you to feel welcome to go back in the back in the Sunday school and acquire a hat and a piece of jewelry. I'll extend the invitation to you still today because I know there was a lot of graduation going on yesterday. So the invitation still stands. So feel free to go back and get you a hat. I did have to leave yesterday because of Hurley being sick. So I got a phone call again. Hurley is going through testing this morning. I left him this morning about 2:30, and he's doing well.
Thank you, Lord.
He's in the right place.
Amen.
He's in the hospital like the church is. For sin sick, his body's sick.
Amen.
So he's there, and they're looking after him. And hopefully, if things work out, they're good today, I won't have to get in it and send him to Dukes because he will go further if K3 does not do what they're supposed to do. But y'all keep him in prayer.
Amen.
He had an issue with that blood pressure. Just pray for Hurley B. Okay, God's got him. But okay. So to God be the glory. So like I say, you're welcome to go back. As soon as service is out though, my sister Rogeline is going to go back and clean things up, putting it away, you know, and then I'll take it from there. But I'm giving you an invitation now to please go back and receive a hat or some jewelry. And while still standing, Mom, stand up, please.
Amen.
Y'all, this is my mother.
Amen.
My mother is 85, will be 86 years old coming up in 2 months.
Amen.
So, and I thank God for giving me my mama. And leaving my mama back here with us as long as he has. But I thank God for that woman because she is why I'm here.
Amen.
And if it was not for her, I wouldn't be here. If it wasn't for me, she wouldn't be here. So I thank God that what he has done.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
So I just want to thank God and thank you and happy Mother's Day. Greg, you got something to say, my brother. So he's been raising his hand the whole time. But I'm raising mine, both of them, and I just thank God. Keep on leaning independent on God.
Amen.
So he's the only one that's going to sustain you.
I'm going to ask that you meet us on Zoom an hour early at 6 p.m. so that we can have our first homecoming launch meeting. I need you there. Listen, y'all, I'm going to say this if you want to get out of here. You know how we do.
Uh-huh.
It's easy to sit back and be like, they should have done this. Man, if I was helping with homecoming, I would have.
Come on.
I'm glad you said that because last year was last year. This year is your
all
chance.
All right.
Seriously, we need everybody who's willing to help and to work. Even if you just want to come in and give your feedback. Y'all know what I'm saying? Don't stay away thinking, well, they're going to put me to work. If you don't have the time to work, at least give us your feedback. Amen? Come on.
Amen.
And so that, again, that is this Wednesday at 6 o'clock p.m. All of those who are our guests and visitors, y'all, just wave your hand. Just wave your hand. If you would like, I tell you, those of you who don't know me, I'm not going to put anybody on the spot.
My Lord.
If you don't want to say anything, don't say anything. But if you would like to, certainly we want to give space to our guests this time. Amen. Yes, sir, my brother.
All right.
Happy to be my sister, my mom. And it's a different feeling when you wait for so many years.
Sure.
And actually, I get home my mom on another day.
That's all right.
Amen.
That's all right. Amen. Glad to be here. Watch this. Watch this, church. He's smiling now. Watch this. Were you glad of the outcome of the game yesterday?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. The cheeks went up. Cheeks went up. I got to meet these young men on yesterday as the Bucks fan. They were very, very respectful, and they very much helped out with the program. And it's good to see young people helping out.
Amen.
And it looks, if they're fooling me, keep on fooling me. But it looked like they were glad to help. And I think that's a very good
Amen.
Thing. So at this time, again, our dear friend, our unofficial member, I told Terry, you're my unofficial member, man. He can't get away from that. But he is here. He is a friend of this church. And I pray that he considers us a friend of him. But he has a special presentation he wants to make to the ladies of Union Oak on this morning at this time. My brother.
Camera, you gonna help me?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Amen. Amen.
Got you covered. So at this time, if you are a lady of Union Oak, I'm gonna ask that you stand to your feet, please. You just stand to your feet.
The ladies are the
matter of fact, y'all got to understand the way my brain works.
Go ahead.
When I say a lady of Union Oak,
yeah.
I mean if you here, stand
That's
up.
Right.
Because
yeah.
here's the deal.
That's
I'm not
right.
trying to make you a member.
Amen.
But if you're here, we're going to give you everything we give the members who are here.
Amen.
There's enough love to go around for everybody.
Amen.
So we've got some beautiful flowers. We're going to hook you up. And so at this time, see you all. It's instead those who are brothers or mothers. But if you are a woman, you have provided some degree of motherly love to somebody.
Thank you.
And we just want to be a blessing to you.
Amen.
This morning, in Sunday school, we had the opportunity to speak about the Proverbs 31 woman. And the Word of God continued to speak about how, you know, we live in a society. It's all about, oh, are her nails done? Is her hair done? That's nice. I mean, if you look around, Union Oak right this morning is filled with beauty.
Amen.
We have beautiful ladies in the house. But the thing is, God's glory does not stop at your physical
beauty. All right.
We have leaders. We have women who know how to prepare. We have women who are an inspiration.
Yes.
We have women who go above and beyond the call of duty. We have women who have made lives of others better, whether they are your birth children or
All
not.
All right.
I challenge the Sunday school to consider this. If you go to any church, and take out all the sisters, what we can have left. Brothers, we do the best we can now. But if all the sisters left the church, I think we'd be in trouble. And so I want to thank Terry McMillan for his desire
Amen.
To be a blessing. Miss McGrew is going to let you guys know we have some other blessings that we want to heap upon the ladies who are here today, and I'll let you give those instructions. But again, I do believe that even in our time of worship, God tells us to not only love our God with our whole heart,
oh my God.
But we are to also love our neighbors
Amen.
As ourselves.
Amen.
And I'm tired, y'all.
Whoa.
I'm telling you what now. Ask my wife. Some of y'all have been there. You never want to be in a place to where the people on the job or the neighbors or even your kinfolk. It's sad when the meanest people are the ones coming to work talking about what they did at church.
Ain't that something?
We have to have the kind of character that exudes love. And I believe it starts with the love that
Woo!
Many of us learn
yes.
from our dear mothers.
Yes.
Union Oak, we love you. We thank you. Now let's give God some praise.
Yeah, hallelujah.
God, I got to have my lookers
on to see what's going on. We know, you know, Pastor said it too, and I don't like to talk about money. So if it's in our budget, we do in November, we have our Mother's Day obligation.
Uh-huh.
So if you don't know what it is, see me after church. And if you don't know what it is, put what you can in today. The asking is $100, and somebody came to me from Fourth Service. Sister McGrew, how much it is we got? And she said, I already got mine.
All right.
So that's why I haven't been reiterating, because most of you know. Thank you so much. And the scripture after the selection is by Sister Ashley McKinnon, a young God-fearing mother of this church. And you can look it up before she comes. You can look and start reading. I done read it two or three times. When our Reverend Gilchrist, when she texted to me a couple weeks ago, I done read two or three times. Last night, last time, about 1:30, I read it again.
My Lord.
2 Timothy, 1st chapter.
Uh-huh.
Verses 3-7.
Amen.
And just in case you missed it, Sister Sabrina have been bold letters. What our Mother's Day theme is. A mother's hug lasts long after she lets go.
Oh, my Lord.
And that's my mom. I can still feel my mother's hug, the people in the neighborhood that were mothers to me. I can still feel them. When they let go, I can still feel that hug.
Our welcome address will come from the screen today. I hope and pray that it works.
And as that is taking place, I'm going to ask that the ushers and stewards go ahead and start getting in position.
Amen.
So that as soon as we finish our welcome, we'll be able to go right into our tithes and our offering. Amen?
Amen.
This computer is by doing it slow, as old as slow. Well, first of all, we welcome you to Union Oak Church today, and we wish all the mothers a very happy Mother's Day. And I'm just going to, you have been greeted by our pastor, you've been greeted by Sister McGrew, and you've been greeted by various other people, and we just want you to know that we are so excited to have you here with us today at Union Oak Church. We are a Bible-believing church where we are being led by a dynamic pastor. And we hope that something is said or done today that will lead you to come back and worship with us again. Thank you for visiting with us today.
Thank you.
put their flowers where they can smell them, you know. But certainly, we are so honored to have the preacher who is here today. Certainly, we give God praise for her sister who is here, the Reverend Shirley McLaughlin. Just wave your hand, Reverend. Amen. Amen. She was at service, and service turned out, and she came to see her, hear her sister preach. Amen. It's good to see that. Family supporting one another. But truly, you are in for a treat, because it's good to study the word. It's more important to live it. I'm going to tell you like that.
Amen.
And I will tell you this, this woman of God has lived the word enough that if she never opened up another set of study notes, she can preach until Jesus chose to come back. Amen. Amen. And so the Reverend Helen Gilchrist is a member, life member of New Bethel AME Zion Church, where she currently serves as leader of leaders, class leaders. Amen.
Amen.
She also would periodically, I don't know if she still does it, but she'll be a Sunday school teacher, Bible school teacher. And if there's any of the children at the church who come with somebody and they don't have nobody to sit with, guess where they're sitting? They sit with Miss Helen. And I say that to say that her love for God's people has always been at the forefront. When she started preaching, everybody was like, oh, I thought you'd been a preacher. Because that's just her life.
Amen.
And you all know people, y'all know people like that.
Yes.
That they're just good, solid Christian folks.
Amen.
And in your mind you think, well, they might be a preacher. I don't know. They're probably a preacher. The way they talk about God, no, they must be a preacher. And that's the way they would speak about the Reverend Helen Gilchrist. You all can call her Reverend, and I'm going to call her Mama. Amen.
Yeah.
Because she is my mother.
Amen.
She is the mother of myself and my sister who is on. Hey, Kim, how you doing?
Yeah.
Amen. And she has done a fantastic job raising us.
Amen.
Rabbit, I don't know if you're on. Reverend McBrennan McLaughlin, I don't know if you're on. But we've got a lot of family who she has had a major hand in helping to support. Y'all hear what I'm saying? It still takes a village.
Amen.
I don't care how far we've come.
Amen.
It still takes a village to raise a child.
Yeah.
We shouldn't get so modern that we forget what God is, where we are. And so, again, I could go on and on, but suffice to say, she is often at the top of her class in her conference and district studies.
Amen.
Because she just likes it. She just likes reading. Sometimes I'm like, Ma, you want to come out of the house? Well, I got to finish reading this book. Well, that's good, Ma. Well, after you finish it, well, I've got a paper I'm going to do for conference studies. Well, Ma, I thought they said you didn't have to work. No, no, I want to make sure I have this because I just feel so equipped. That's what
that's
God
right.
wants from us.
Amen.
To truly hunger and thirst for righteousness' sake.
Amen.
So, dear Reverend, if you would please come to the podium at this time. And at this time, I've asked the choir to go ahead and hang loose, and she's just going to get right into the word.
Amen.
We have Miss Ashley who's going to come and give us the scripture at this time. And after you hear the scripture from Miss Ashley McKinnon,
Amen.
The next voice you will hear is that from none other than the preacher of the hour, the wife of David Gilchrist Sr., my father, praise the Lord,
All right.
and the mother of her children and the surrogate mother to so many others, the Reverend Helen Gilchrist.
Amen.
Give God praise at this time.
Amen. Scripture again is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 3 through 7. I thank God, whom I serve, as my ancestors did, with a clear conscience, as night and day I constantly remember you in my prayers. Recalling your tears, I long to see you, so that I may be filled with joy. I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and lived in your mother Eunice. And I am also persuaded now lives in you. For this reason, I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands.
Yeah.
For the Spirit of God gave us, for the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power
mm-hmm.
and
Amen.
Self-discipline.
Yeah.
The word of God for the people of
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Amen.
Give God some praise over this man. Let him know that you love him. Let him know that you know him. And let him know that you are thankful for what he has done for you. Ah, what he's done for you before, what he's doing for you now, and what he's going to do for you in the future. morning. Let us bow our heads. God, in the name of Jesus, come before you right now, loving and praising you, God. And oh, merciful Father, as you have prepared this message for your people, God, decrease me as you increase, God. Ah, Lord, give them a word that it will take them through the rest of their life. I won't say today, tomorrow, but for the rest of their life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Well, I say good morning. I'm not sure about my time, but I say good morning to you this today, and to your pastor, Reverend David Gilchrist, First Lady Makita, and family there, and the Union Oak Church family, and our social media friends. We don't ever want to leave them out. I thank God for this morning and for the opportunity that you have given to me, Mrs. McGrew, to come and speak, and Reverend Gilchrist, to come and speak on this special occasion, Mother's Day. This is a special day, am I right?
Yeah.
If it were not for mothers, you wouldn't be here. If it were not for mothers, we wouldn't have the President of the United States. If it weren't for mothers, we wouldn't have anybody here. So we look to God and tell him, thank you for another day. And I feel right at home. Why? Because my brothers and my sisters and my loved ones are all here. And thank you, Reverend McLaughlin, for joining us on this day, and for Kimberly on line here. As I communicated with Mrs. McGrew, I was informed that the Mother's Day theme is a mother's hug lasts long after she lets go. Now, you think about that thing now, and it says a mother's hug lasts long after she lets go.
Okay.
And that means wherever mother is, even in the grave, wherever mother is, her hug is still resonating in my spirit. I pondered for a while when she said that, and Ms. McGrew gave me the theme, and I thought, well, you know what? Now, I got four grandchildren, and one is about to go to high school, and one is in elementary, and the other two are kind of small here. But if I were to tell them, come up here, David and Solomon, I want to give you a hug. And of course, the two little ones, you know, they're running in a heartbeat. But I think they would readily come forward. But if I were to fail to call my daughter and son, David and Kimberly, up, they wouldn't think a thing about it.
Right.
Why? Because they know that their mother's hug has lasted long after she has given them that hug before. They are now married, they have their own family, and now they are giving the hugs to their children. The younger ones would readily accept the hug because the relationship with that hug is physical and it still is being developed. But the older ones, their hug, their relationship with mother is solid, it is divine, it is spiritual. It has been cultivated and planted in their hearts.
Amen.
Now this relationship is solid because it has been developed 9 months while the baby's in the womb, and they're rubbing and they're singing and they're doing all kind of things. And then it continued on at the conception of that child. And at birth, the baby's placed on the mother up here in the heart there in the breast area. And the physical bonding begins. Physical means I'm touching her. But it begins, and it is that mother's love that she has for her children that is frequently demonstrated through that hug. That causes that mother's love to last long after she has let go. And there's a writer named Matheson and other writers who write about hugs, and I discovered that there are different types of hugs. And the effect on these people, whether it's mother, child, or whoever, it is a physical thing here now. And it provides that mental and emotional closeness between two people, whether they be mom and child or whoever. And whether that hug is from mom's shoulder, in the front, in the back, on the side, or right here on the shoulder, where I come behind that child and I touch them them know that mom is right here. They're going through something, but once that mom touches them, they are relaxed, and you go on, and they're going on back their business. There's that friendly hug where you just go by. You know, the kid just came from school, and you just go by and you touch them, and you hug them a little bit, and they look at you and smile. That is that friendly hug. And then there's that waist hug around the waist when you come by and you just grab them and you tell them hello and I love you. There's that one-sided hug where you gotta let them know. The mom, dad, caregiver, we are all here for you. So don't ever worry, because we are here for you. And then there's that big old one who what is called a bear hug. You know how you grab your babies and they want to frown a little bit, and then they bust out the laughing, and then they embrace your hug that you have given to them. That is that exchange of energy from you to them. It is emotional and it lasts forever. So we may ask ourselves, why do we hug our children or our parents or even our friends? And our answer should always be because our hug transcends the feeling of friendship, of love, of understanding, and of fellowship. Therefore, causing the mother's hug to last long after she lets go. And when our children go off to daycare or kindergarten, elementary school or middle school, mother's hugs are so important because moms are still what? Nurturing, cultivating, and educating these children about the basic skills centered around love. Amen. But when they go to high school, someone's finna hit high school, when they go to high school, to college, and moves out of the house, those hugs for mom, dad, and the caregivers, they will be present, but guess what? They are not as frequent. But guess what? The spiritual part remains with them. And that love, even though it is not as much, it is still there in their hearts. And that memory that they have will bring a smile on their faces and a reassurance that everything is going to be all right. Because mom is praying for me. And I feel God's presence. They will know that God's mystical divine presence is always with them. And that's what we want them to always remember. Mothers have been given this awesome but wonderful responsibility from God. You know, you just didn't get it on your own, but this is from God to raise up his children in the way that they should go. And in our scripture, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 3 through 7, we find Timothy, who was a product of this rearing. He was surrounded with love and godly teachings from his mother, Eunice, and his grandmother, Lois. And yes, Paul, who was the Timothy's spiritual father, he was right there in his life as well. They all remember the great commission Jesus gave to his disciples. Matthew 28, 19, 20. And it reads this way. It says, go and make disciples of all nations. Help the people to learn of me, to believe in me, and to obey my word, baptizing them in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe everything that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you, always remaining with you continuously, whether you are in trouble or whether you are not. Whether you're remaining to do whatever you're doing, God is always in it, regardless of the circumstance. Just know that you are never alone because he will be with you even to the end of age. And that means forever and ever and ever. And as mothers, fathers, and as caregivers, we are all responsible to help our children learn about God, to believe in him, and to obey God's word. We do this, first of all, by establishing a right relationship with who? With God. And by believing in him, and by teaching his word to our children, and by constantly praying. praying for them in Sunday school. And this morning, the song and the prayer and all of this, you and the choir back here, all talking about praying for each other. So we got to be prayers here. As we have established our right relationship with God, let us embrace our children with hugs and love as we introduce them to God. And as we introduce them, thereby helping them to develop this right relationship with Him. They don't know when they come in, they don't know anything. They're born just nothing. But you gotta what, mold them and make them and show them, direct them, and let them learn of you. You gotta tell them the right stuff, though. Am I right? You gotta tell them the right stuff. And in developing this right relationship with God, we thank our mothers, our fathers, and caregivers who nurture, inspire, and teach the children every day. Think about the school teachers. They're there nourishing and instructing your children. But in your guiding and instructing them, I want to ask you a question.
All right.
What will your legacy be for them? What will they remember about you? Will they be able to say, my mother prayed for me? She had me on her mind, took the time and prayed for me. Or will they say, I got the victory because of what mama has taught me? Or will they be able to say, no matter what may come or go, my life is in your hand. With Jesus, I know I can make it. My life is in your hand. And if you are being faithful to God, following His instructions and obeying His commands, then you too, like Lois and Eunice in the book of Timothy, can emphatically say, I am teaching them, my children, about God and about His love. And as we read in verse 5, Paul tells Timothy that he is reminded of his sincere faith, which first lived in his grandmother Lois and in his mother Eunice, and now I am persuaded, I'm convinced that it now lives in you. Paul recognized that sincere faith of Timothy, grandmother, who passed it on to his mother, and then both of them, not just mom, but both of them passed it on to Timothy. They were believers. They were believers. So my first point to you this morning is, mothers, you must be believers. You must be believers. In order for Timothy's grandmother, Lois, and his mother, Eunice, to influence him, they needed to be believers in God. Believers in God. They were early converts born into the Jewish faith. And they accepted Christianity and became believers of God, in God, under the leadership of Paul's ministry. And in the home, watch this, in the home, Lois and Eunice worked as a team. They didn't work against each other. They worked as a team, laying the foundation for Timothy by teaching the scriptures to him and helping him to be a godly man of God. In Acts 16, it tells us that Timothy's father was a Greek. But I thank God because the strong women in his home, they taught him and they put him in the right places where he got the guidance and instruction that he needed to be a Christian. That is what mother's hugs are all about. And love of moms, it is to give it to your children so they can what? Carry it on. Secondly, mothers, we must be teachers. We can't only be the believers, because I believe in God, but don't keep it right there. You got to pass it on. So now you are becoming teachers. Paul credits Lois and Eunice as Timothy's teachers, okay? He recognizes their godly influence in teaching the scriptures to Timothy as the groundwork that enabled him to have a sincere faith. Mothers, you know that, right? You got to train them and let them know what God is, who God is in their life. And then they will become sincere faith builders, faith leaders, faith persons. And not only that, they will have it on their own. I know mom is a Christian. I know mom loves God. Hey, but what about me? Don't ever let them say, what about me? You let it grow up in them. Sunday to the mothers and the fathers and the caregivers. We cannot rely, come on now, we cannot rely on schools to give your children hugs or even teach them godly principles, morals, and ethics. Say it again. You cannot rely on school or watch this, anybody else, to give them the hugs and the training that they need in order for them to become strong, godly people. Those hugs and teachings, they gotta come from home. They gotta come from you. And I once heard a lady say that her son was cursing at the elementary school. And then, of course, she heard him in the backyard. And that troubled her spirit. And she said, I don't understand, because that is not what goes on in my house. And so then she took him to the doctor. And of course, what you think the doctor gonna say? It's gonna be all right. You just keep on, you know, it's gonna be all right. This too will go, he'll grow out of it, and this too will pass. That's a big concern. Mm-hmm. When you don't know the unknown. Yeah. When I'm in a hospital, I don't know the unknown. Yeah. When I leave my children forever, I don't know the unknown. Yeah. But I do know who holds the unknown in his hand. And if I know who holds it in his hand, I can give him a call and tell him, Lord, thank you, because he is the one. Yeah. And so I say to you, keep on hugging. Keep on praying. Yeah. Keep on teaching. Yeah. Keep on explaining and disciplining your children. Yeah. And then pray some more. Yeah. Keep on praying. Yeah. And eventually, this too shall pass. Her son is now a college professor, and he's doing just fine. So I say to you, keep hugging your children and placing them before the Lord with the word of God, and everything will work out. Yeah. Everything will work out. They will cherish every hug that they've ever had, even after it is long gone. Yeah. They will have their own sincere faith in God. Just keep putting them before God. Yeah. Keep putting them before God. As Lois and Eunice continue to put Timothy before God, he continued to grow in his faith, thus becoming Apostle Paul's assistant and his mentee. Yeah. Now you see that? Because if you keep cultivating them and motivating them, if you keep putting them out there and training them, they will keep on going. Yeah. Apostle Paul, we all know about Paul, Apostle Paul. Yeah. And so he was his assistant and his mentee. Paul constantly remembered Timothy in his prayers. After Paul's second and third missionary journeys with Timothy, they separated. Yeah. But Paul went one way, and Timothy stayed behind, watching and helping out at the church in Ephesus. Yeah. So now he is over the church, trying to help them to what? Grow and be all that they can be.
Yes.
So mom, thoroughly can only be a believer. Now once you start teaching, you can't stay there either, can you?
Right.
You can't be the believer and the teacher, but you gotta be a prayer warrior.
Yeah.
You gotta put them before the Lord.
Yes.
You gotta let them know that God is always with them.
Yes.
So in our scripture, Paul is now in prison and not able to move about freely.
Yeah.
He was about to die, and he wanted to encourage Timothy one more time.
Yes.
And therefore he writes his last letter.
Yes.
He still remembers Timothy's sincere faith in God and his love, which developed through his mother and his grandmother Eunice. Now I want you to understand something. When we are talking about mother and grandmother, watch this, aunties and uncles, watch this, friends and community leaders. We are talking about all of us, am I right? You gotta understand, the picture is a big picture here. And when we say it takes the village to raise a child, you better know it takes the village to raise that child. But we all need encouraging at times, am I right? So Paul constantly prayed and put Timothy before God, and he called his son in the faith, this is my child, bless him, God.
Yeah.
And a strong leader in the church, Lord, bless him there as well. Then as Paul was praying for Timothy, guess what? Timothy was praying for Paul.
Yeah.
It's a two-way street, you guys. You're saying, well, I don't know why my class leader's not praying for me. I don't know why my pastor's not praying for me. But understand this. It is a two-way street, and we have to pray for each other. We others? Do you pray for others or do you just pray for yourself?
Yeah.
As we set godly examples before our children and teach them, we must teach them how to pray and what to pray for. Yeah. You know, teach my old lady, Lord, but tell them what they need to pray for.
Yes.
Why should I tell them? How would they know if you don't tell them?
Yes.
Somebody's got to tell them.
Yes.
We must teach them to pray for everyone, those who are good to them and those that are not, those that love them and those that don't. I pray for the completion of assignments for these kids that are in school. But guess what? Assignments are done all day long. Right here, I'm hearing them talking about homecoming. Assignments there. Pray for those assignments that God will take you through with them. But for our sweethearts, our babies, they're in school. So we got to teach them to pray. Let us stay alert as we're preaching and teaching them. And as we're doing that, those assignments, I heard the EOG coming up. We got to pray. If the kid, I don't have any children, grandmas and others, you pray for Union Oak Park children.
Yeah.
You don't be selfish. Don't stay there. Pray for the children everywhere that God will bless them and bless them abundantly.
Yes.
We must pray and teach them to pray for their principal at school, their teachers at school, because sometimes they're up against a whole lot, aren't they?
Yes.
But you got to pray that God will take them through every time. I saw her saying, I don't know whether I'm going to make it because my exam, I didn't do good, and I didn't do this over here. But you pray, and God has a way of working things out for you and bringing it to a fusion. I'm bringing it to a conclusion here. And guess what? You will be A-OK. Listen, pray for your pastor and pray for your church members. Don't be selfish. I'm praying for New Bethel. No, I'm praying for all the churches planted by the hand of God.
Yes.
So pray. Paul encouraged Timothy to persevere as he was praying for him. He told him, persevere and use the gift that God has bestowed upon you. Are you using your gift that God gave you? Are you a singer? Now, hear the little spirit singing beautifully. And the young lady beautifully. Are you using the gifts that God has given to you? It might not be singing. It might not be preaching. It might not be on the ball field. It might not be on whatever, right? But whatever he has blessed you with, you use it to his glory. Now, the thing is, Timothy had the spiritual gift. Why? Because Paul and the elders had laid their hands on him.
Yeah.
Some of you might not know what that is. But in the olden days, whenever I was a little kid, they laid hands on you. They told you to come up and pray, and they laid their hands on you. And when you came up, I don't know about those of my age here, when you came up, didn't you feel differently? You felt differently because you were in the spirit. You were in the spirit. And so Timothy needed to be bold. He needed to be bold. And not only that, Paul is telling him, you use your spiritual gifts.
Yes, Lord.
You use your spiritual judgment.
Yes.
Now, Timothy, watch this. I don't care where you are. Somebody going to challenge you. Am I right?
Yes.
Timothy was challenged by believers. Now, I didn't say non-believers, did I? Timothy was challenged by believers who opposed his message from God.
Yes.
Who opposed his leadership. They opposed his youthfulness.
Yep.
What would happen if we oppose the youth? The young men or young women that are in the church trying to carry on.
Yeah.
What if you oppose them?
Yeah.
That's God's servant.
Yes.
But at any rate, they not only oppose his youthfulness, but they oppose his association with Paul.
Yeah.
They say, friends, the association with Paul. Isn't that a sad state?
Yeah.
You in church and the man of God preaching, teaching, and trying to get you where you want to be. So whatever condition you find yourself in, you pray to God.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, what happened? All the problems go away.
Yeah.
And you stop and say, God, I thank you.
Yeah.
I thank you.
Yeah.
Because we know you can do it, but God could.
Thank you.
So being Timothy's father, watch this now. Being Timothy's father in the ministry, Paul urged Timothy, you stand your ground.
Yes.
You don't allow them to talk down to you. You don't allow them whether your friends or your enemies, your dress does not matter. Yeah. Don't allow them to take you down. Yeah. Because when you do, and it looks like you're weak, not only that, you are now ineffective trying to do the will of the Father who has sent you. And so I can imagine Timothy remembering his mother and his grandmother teachings and how they were grounded in the Lord when confronted with conflict. And so, two mothers, we must stand our ground and let our children see the strength of the Lord in us, and that those hugs of assurance and confidence given to them will support them just like they supported us from our moms and our grandmothers. And so as we stand our ground, God has gifted us with the Holy Spirit, which will propel us to do God's work. He will allow us to bear good fruit, love, peace, joy, happiness, unacceptable. It will allow us to bear that good fruit. Yes. Let the Holy Spirit, our hugs, our living, and our examples show others, our children especially, and those who are in our care, that we are bearing good fruit. Yes. So be encouraged, mothers, fathers, caregivers. Rejoice. Amen. Your living is not in vain. Your hugs are not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15 tells us, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Now, knowing that it's not in vain in the Lord, right? You can't have it on your own, but it's got to be in the Lord. And so all the work that we do, just remember, all the work that we do for Christ, it will be rewarded. So don't feel bad if nobody wants to go with you. Don't feel bad if nobody hooks on to you. Don't feel bad if people want to talk about you and all of that. But you go on anyhow. Because your mom has laid the foundation. And her hugs are rooted and grounded in you. And so now you are able to go forth and do the thing that you need to do. So that you can be what? Rewarded also. As we hug our children and nurture them, remember the words to this point that talks about our children, our hugs, and our legacy. We're gonna leave behind, right? And our legacy. It is entitled, Children Learn What They Live. And it is by Dorothy Arnotti. And it goes like this, with my interjections. If our children live with criticism, they will learn to condemn. If they live with hostility, they will learn to fight. If they live with ridicule, they will learn to be shy. If our children live with shame, they will learn to feel guilty. But I thank God, because there's another side to this thing. Moms, there's another side to it. Because if our children live with tolerance, they will learn to be patient, okay? Patient with you, patient with others, and what? Patient with themselves. If our children live with encouragement, they will learn confidence. And if they live with praise, they will learn to appreciate. Praise your children. Don't just say they know, they understand. Praise your children. And when it's not, like Donovan is 1 year old, and we praise him when he does little things. Solomon is 14 years old, and we praise him when he does things. Praise your children. David, when he does, Reverend Gilchrist, when he does stuff. We praise him, and all of praise them. If your husband does something, praise him. If your father does something, praise him. And if they live with fairness, they will learn justice. In this world today with voting rights and all of that going to wherever it's going, we gotta pray for justice. And if they live with security, I'm secured at my mom and dad's home. But if they live with security, they will learn to have what? Faith in God, faith in man, and faith in themselves. But if our children live with approval, they will learn to like themselves. How can I like like myself and don't like, I mean, how can I like you? I love you, but I don't even like myself.
Yeah.
So it's got to first, what? I appreciate who I am.
Yeah.
But you got to know yourself, right?
Yeah.
You got to know what you believe in. You got to know who you are.
Yeah.
So that when I do what I do, I do it because I know God loves me.
Yes.
And if our children live with acceptance and
Amen.
Friendship, they will learn to find love in this world.
Yeah.
They will learn to find love in this world.
Yes.
God is what?
Love.
God is love.
Yes.
And so if I got God, I got love.
Yes.
And if I got love, it's got to be the what? God is love, but I got love as well.
Yes.
So they will learn to find love in this world.
Yes.
Yes.
Mothers, that love you give begins in the womb.
Amen.
Continues at birth when the child is first placed on the mother's chest. You embrace the baby with a loving and godly hug. A loving and godly hug. And the rest is history.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Because your hug will continue long after you let go. Mothers, happy Mother's Day. Anybody who has a hand in children, we say happy Mother's Day. Why? Because you are connected
yeah.
with your mother.
Amen.
So again, may God bless you and have a smile upon you
yes.
and do you good.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. Bless the Lord. I'm going to get my mother's hug right now. Amen. Amen. Best believe I'm never going to get so high up that my mama can't call me by the name that she gave me. I might be Reverend Gilchrist's son, but at the end of the day, I'm her son. Praise the Lord. And the reason I say that is because there are many of us who have found ourselves in situations. And she spoke about how God's love is shown through the mother. And many of us are in a place right now to where we feel like God has forgotten us. And maybe it's because of choices we've made. Maybe it's because we ain't been in church since the last Mother's Day. Maybe it's because I'm in church, but the church is not in me. But I'm here to encourage you on this morning. The woman of God just spoke it and said that God will show his love. She spoke about a mother's hug that lasts forever. But I'm so glad that when God gives me the hug of his son Jesus, even when I find myself straying away, even when I find myself making a mistake, even when I find myself in a place that I know I shouldn't be, I can say, God, I thank you that you haven't given up on me. Oh, I'm going to ask you to stand all over the building on this morning. The word was spoken and the word was preached. And yes, this was a Mother's Day message with a Mother's Day theme. But the overall theme was love. And I don't know, I mean, I can't tell your story like you can, but all of us are only here because of something that somebody poured into us. Y'all see what I'm saying? The only reason we're here, we're all in different places, different situations. This first appeal is this. There's such a thing called a relationship with Jesus Christ. Don't get it twisted. Everybody that's up in church don't have a relationship. They might have a dedication. They might be good people. I'm not taking nothing away from that. But the word of God says, if you accept Jesus, you've got to accept that he died, that
yes.
he was raised again, then you shall be saved.
Amen.
Heard a man of God saying that a lot of times at homegoing services or what we call funerals, we want to try to preach somebody into heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we don't know what a person's last 30 seconds of life was
That's
like.
That's right.
But it doesn't do us any good to get up here.
That's right.
Because that's a personal thing. So I say that to say this. She spoke of how a parent or a mother can pour in. But right now, it's not about your mama or your dad or your grandma. It's about you. And if you know you haven't accepted Jesus Christ, don't wait. Don't wait. You politely love somebody. Excuse me, I got to get to the
Amen.
Altar. But you know what I'm going to say? This is a little different.
You know, in church, we tell people to come to the altar. If you want to give your life to Christ, but something is keeping you from stepping out, I need you to slip your hand up and I'm going to come to you.
Go ahead.
If maybe you're just that person and I'm uncomfortable, then I got it. I got it. Don't let that be your reason that you leave out of here unsaved. Slip your hand up. I will come to you and pray with you right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm looking around. Let me check my choir stand. Amen. Check that Zoom feed. There might be somebody in the chat right now that say, I'm not there, but I'm going to give my life to Christ.
That's all right.
Amen. We're about making disciples.
My God.
Amen. Maybe you're somebody that says, hey, I'm saved, but honestly and truthfully, I just want prayer this morning. There's some things going on in my life. There's some stuff I'm dealing with. And honestly speaking, I'm tired of caring about what other people are going to say.
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, I've been needing prayer for the last 2 months, but I didn't come out because I figured people was going to talk about me. But at this point, I can't sit here no longer. And if that's you, will you come?
Amen. Thank you, God.
We got to learn how to get what we need from God.
Amen.
We got to learn how we need to get what we need to get from God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Keith. Amen. To God be the glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Yes, ma'am. I see you in the chat. We will make sure to lift up the name of God on your behalf, Mr. Bell. Yes, ma'am. That's right. You never forget. You're on Zoom, but you are part of this worship service.
Amen.
That's why I thank God for the technology that allows us to be connected even when we're not physically together.
Amen.
We're going to lift you up in prayer, my sister. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got to learn how to get what we need from God. I'm going to say this and I'm going to get out your way. But at the end of the day, if somebody told you they was dropping off $500 checks, trust to know, we wouldn't stand looking cute. We would do what we have to do to get what we need.
Amen.
But I'm going to ask that wherever you are, go ahead and take your seat at this time. And as you're sitting down, don't just look, don't just watch, but pray with us and pray for us as we now go to God in prayer. Oh, God, I thank you on this morning, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God, for the message that came, oh, God. And the message was resonating loud and clear, God. The love that you have imparted in us, God, remains even in the midst of challenging circumstances and situations, God. And right now, we lift up all of your people, God. We lift them up to you, oh God. You're looking around, God, right now, the altar railing. And you're looking right now in the Zoom chat, God. And you're looking, God, even in the pews, Lord. I'm praying right now, God, that you move by your anointing, God, in some kind of way, God, that somebody, God, on Monday or Tuesday, maybe Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Thursday, next Sunday, God, but something's going to happen, God. They're going to look back. And they're going to say, oh, my God, it was the prayers. It was the prayer that have gone forth that moved this situation. Right now, in the name of Jesus, God, we're even praying for that which is not known to pray for, God. Oh, God, those demonic spirits, God, which are coming forth to attack your people, God. We arrest them in the name of Jesus, God, that even before the attack comes, God, it's a shield and a hedge around them, God. That this week, God, your people will walk in your anointing. Strengthened, God, delivered and set free like only you can. We pray, God, that you touch the heart of those who are grieving right now. Who are struggling and wanting to be happy because it is Mother's Day. But the natural humanity is causing certain challenges as they remember their mothers no longer here. Some who had trying and challenging relationships with their mother view this day differently. And God, those who perhaps have lost a child, and they view Mother's Day in a day of pain, touch them, God, like only you can. God, we thank you for the mothers who are here. We thank you for the families which have been made stronger because of the matriarchs
which have sacrificed and poured into us, we declare victory on this morning. We thank you, God. And we know that everything will be as you have. God, we thank you. And we give you all the glory. Now, if you agree with that prayer, I challenge you to give God the best praise that you can. Hallelujah! 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 God, I thank you. Hallelujah. While you're praising God, while you're giving God the glory, right now in the spirit realm, God is working some things out. You prayed your prayer. Now you're praising God. And as you're giving God the glory, there are things being worked out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go in peace. And may the peace of God which passes understanding be with you this week. Hallelujah. To God be all of the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. We thank God for all of you who are here this morning. Hallelujah. We praise God in the name of Jesus for his presence. Those of you who have joined us this morning because it is Mother's Day, I want to thank you. You could have just as easily waited to meet mom at the restaurant later. So the fact that you all came out, we want you to know we thank you. And please know that you are always welcome here at UNO. You don't have to make an invitation. You don't got to call nobody. Just drop on by to the Big O and come get a word from the Lord. Again, we want to take a moment to thank the preacher of the hour. Amen. 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 Ms. McGrew, you have done a fantastic job.
Amen. Amen.
Come on.
All right now.
Amen.
Come on. Amen.
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 This is a new member. She's been working in the church a long time. And she told... She had been to different churches.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
I'm Sister Johnson, and I was in a CME church. I migrated here from New York, and I went all over North Carolina trying to find a CME church, and there's none in Fayetteville, so I must have visited over 20-something churches. And the first time I came to Union Oak, I just felt something and with that, and then the people, how they just welcomed me in, I just knew this is where I wanted to be.
Amen.
This is where I want to worship and praise the Lord. So I thank you, Union Oak, for welcoming me. I love you.
Yes.
I love you. Happy Mother's Day to your
mother.
May God bless you and be with you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And we have a special presentation. I'll let you get on that. I know it's time. Sister Johnson has a special answer to Lily. At where you see? Where you see? We're gonna do the remarks now to presentation. Sister Lily has and. What we're going to do on some of the presentation we have for the mothers. We have some goodies back there in the back. It's already boxed up, so just get you one. We have some roses. We thank the gentleman for giving us carnations.
Amen.
But we have some roses too for the
ladies. Amen.
And get one of those. And happy Mother's Day. And take your mom, sister, your cousin out
you leave okay.
For a relaxing. Don't let them go home and go fry some chicken. No, don't let them go home and do that. Fix, do something for me. We got to go and bring it and box it in. But first, we would have our first lady, Sister Lily. Okay. But while she's doing that, we'll get
speaker. Reverend Helen Gilchrist, could you come to the corner right there, please?
So, well, you know what, Sister Gilchrist, I'm so glad that you and First Lady are here, because I had these baskets specially made from New York and sent to me, and one says Nana and the other one says Mother. So I forgot what she told me, so I'm over here trying to look. So if you see Nana, that's your back. If you see Nana, that's okay. So on behalf of Union Oak, we'd like to thank you for coming out, giving us that awesome word.
Amen.
We love you, and it's just a token of our love.
Oh,
happy Mother's
Day. While she's doing that, it's just Reverend Gilchrist. Brother Allen, I thought you were going to get, let me take my glasses off. I'm going to give you, and this right here is a flower. I looked at and tried to see if they have two. When I bought it, I will get one for me. This right here. This is for you. You can hang it wherever you want to hang it at. And we love you. We love you. And thank you, thank you, thank you for the word.
Yeah.
We got masks on. We're going to put this.
Daniel, come here. Quickly, come get this for Grandma. Here you go, sir. Thank you. Here you go. There you go. Thank you, sir.
And at this time,
we fall down, but we get up.
And that concludes, I'm turning over to the hands of the pastor, but like I said, in the back.
So, we didn't forget about the rest of you mothers here, so we did put a little something together as a token of our love and appreciation for you all. So after service, just please come in the back.
The senior mothers, we have something for you also. I think
yes.
We have your name on it, don't
yes,
you?
Those okay. Mothers that were sick and shut in, I got a list of the names, and we just
Pay
the bag for you all too.
Amen.
So if you're not here, your bag is in the bag.
Amen. The mother that's here, when you get a bag and a rose, and the one that's not here, if we don't have a... Once we do that, then we might can, you know, if we don't have enough, then we have to do what. The main thing, we want the ones to get here to get one and get a rose. And we love you. And like I said before, you don't have to, well, I don't have any children. Look how many children that you helped raise. He's at school, on your job, in your neighborhood. So you still are a mother. Thank you so much.
This is what the hugs do. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And we want to thank you. But I really want to thank Union Oak. You know, you have you've taken my son and daughter and children in, and you've poured love into them that I'm looking at and I'm saying, thank you, Lord. And they come home and they're so excited about things that are going on. I thank you. And as I say, you are now my family because this is my son, so you are my family. And the young lady that said, I'm not sure who it was, but I want to call you. And she called me mom, and she said, I hope you know. But okay, there she is. So no, I don't mind, okay? I take all I can get, okay? God bless you all, and happy Mother's Day again.
Yeah, I wanted, they asked me, they said, well, Pastor, we want to do something for your wife and your mother. I'm not going to say no to that. I've been living too long. I'm smart enough. But I do want to thank you for your patience. Listen, my members, y'all tell your family and friends, tell them to come back. Y'all know we normally out of here at about 12:15. I seen y'all. I've been watching. I seen about 8 hands do like this right here at some point or another. I'll be looking. I do. But we only get one Mother's Day out the year. Amen. Amen. And so again, I want to thank you for your patience. I do, and I pray that the chicken tastes just as good now as it would have a few minutes ago, okay? But again, we do want you to go down to the back as our expression of love. Again, thank you, Terry. You know, brother, the door is always open. And for anybody, Union Oak is a place where love and fellowship abound. At this time, let us look to the Lord. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. To the only wise God be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Let us all sing together.
Mother's Day, everybody. Take care.